What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to week 11 of the Axial Honcho Budget Build. This week is one of my favorite weeks of the build because this week we get to install a new set of beadlocks. We're going to be installing the brand new Incision KMC Machete 1.9 plastic beadlocks. These beadlocks are a perfect fit for the budget build because they're $24.99 a pair. So they fit perfectly into our week 11 budget without going over at all. I've been excited to install these on the truck since before this build started. I knew that these would be coming and they finally hit. We're finally able to put them on and we can get to talking about all of the features that these plastic beadlocks have. These are a true beadlock wheel that use an aluminum inner and outer beadlock ring, and they have an adjustable hub design. So any Incision hub will bolt right up to this wheel. These wheels include in the package two different size wheel hubs to let you adjust your track width. They come with a number 4 pre-installed on the wheel, and they also come with a number 7 in the package as well. The wheels use 6 screws to attach the hub through the wheel. To help from the hardware wanting to pull through the wheel face, there's also a reinforcing washer that goes between the hardware and the wheel face, just giving you a little bit more surface area for that hardware to bite against. This should help with the longevity and durability of these wheels for the long run. These wheels also have a removable KMC XD center cap. The removable center cap allows you to have the nice scale look of wheel hubs on all 4 corners, or you can remove them for the easy access to that wheel nut. Now, back when we very first started this build, I mounted up these ProLine BFGs onto the stock plastic wheels, but I knew that I would be installing beadlocks in the long run, so I only used 4 spots of glue on the front and back side of the tires to hold them in place. So removing them from the plastic wheels was pretty straightforward. All I had to do was just kind of pull at them a little bit and use my knife just to clean up a little bit of the glue that was holding the tires on. Overall, that process was super simple and didn't take much time. The actual installation of the tires onto the beadlocks and the beadlocks onto the car, pretty simple as well. I do want to run through that, just show you exactly what it takes. These new Incision KMC Machete wheels come pre-assembled with the screws just loosely in place, but you will need to back out all of the beadlock screws between 1/4 and 5/16 of an inch just to give you enough room to be able to fit the tire in. You'll need to do this on both the front and back side of the wheel. And then you'll also need to remove the 6 screws around the removable hub in the center of the wheel. Once all 6 screws from the center of the wheel are loosened completely, you can remove the hub from the back side. You will find that there is a new wheel nut for you to use with these wheels on the inside of that wheel assembly. Now, this is the exact same style wheel nut that you had before. It's not special or anything like that. It's just a new wheel nut to replace maybe a worn out one that you might be using. Now, with all 6 of the screws removed, you can remove that center cap from the face of the wheel. Now, this new center cap is a 2-piece design. It has a washer that goes around the outside to reinforce where the screws go into the wheel, and then it has that center cap. You can remove that center cap if you want easier access to your wheel nuts. If you want the easiest access, leave this out and reinstall with only that center washer, but don't install this wheel without using that center washer. If you want the scale looks of having a center cap, then keep this inserted into that washer. I'm going to install this on my truck using that center cap. So we're gonna put this plastic Incision number 4 hub onto the axle and tighten the wheel nut on it first. With all of those beadlock screws loosened, we have plenty of room between the beadlock ring and the wheel surface to reinsert our ProLine tire. Push the wheel in through the tire and then begin to get the beads pushed into the grooves between the beadlock ring and the wheel surface. With everything loosely put in place, make sure that the bead is put into the groove all the way around. You can look into the gap between the beadlock ring and the wheel just to make sure that everything looks like it's pressed all the way in and there's nothing interfering with it before you start tightening those screws down. To seat the bead, tighten the screws in a star pattern and just keep revolving around. Don't tighten all the way down at once, just do a little bit at a time and keep working your way around. With the beadlock screws all tightened down and the hub installed on the axle, we're going to place the wheel onto that hub, and then we're going to reinstall the center cap and washer onto the wheel with the 6 screws that surround it.
So installing a set of tires onto a set of beadlocks, not that difficult, but makes a huge difference in looks
and the ease of playing with your tires, playing with your foams, wanting to adjust things easily. Overall, there's nothing that I'd rather run other than a set of beadlocks. I'm glad that there was finally time to get them into this build, and I'm glad that these are on the market now. And since it's so simple to install a set of beadlocks, I figured that I'd throw in a bunch of bonus footage from this last weekend when I took this truck out on the rocks with the new KMC machete beadlocks and had some fun. I just want to thank all of you for watching for this long. We're 11 weeks in and not slowing down yet. Tons of things to still do to this truck. Really looking forward to this build continuing. Let me know which of the weeks you guys have found the most helpful and if there's anything else you would like to see as we progress still. So before we get on to the running footage, I just want to say thanks again for watching. Like the video if you enjoyed it, subscribe if you're not already, and enjoy the rest of the video.